Lars Greve. I'm a saxophone player and clarinet player and composer. And for the last year or so, I've been doing an artistic research project at the conservatory in Copenhagen. And my project has been to discover the artistic potentials in improvising on my instrument in a room which has some acoustics or vibe to it. And then also bringing selected objects into vibration. I can explain it by saying that I'm attached drivers you can say pipes like we have here in this room, or a metal wall. So I put these drivers on and they start to vibrate when I play. They basically just amplify what I'm playing. So the sound comes from a clarinet, from a microphone, to an amplifier and to these transducers or drivers. And basically that's it, then music starts. What I've been really interested in is resonance. So when is there some kind of a feedback between me and the objects? Because you could say everything is vibrating, even the world is vibrating now. You just can't hear it. But resonance is something that happens when there's some kind of, I guess you can call it, coherence between two frequencies, and this feedback starts. So suddenly, if you see it in this room or hear it in this room, you can suddenly hear that there's a snare to the pipe. So there's something more than just a straight amplification of the clarinet sound. And I think that's really interesting because I can interplay with the room and on a more sophisticated level than I can if it was just me as an improviser in a room, like adding that the room is sounding and even bringing sound to me adds a lot more. So that's been my artistic research project, like main question. A goal has also been to make a room or a listening format or a place to hear music, basically, that is just as engaging for the audience as it is to me. As an improviser, I'm constantly driven by finding new sounds, finding new ways of exploring music. And sometimes I feel that that's, if I'm in a normal setting with a concert, I feel that I'm just showcasing that to an audience, and they need to invest a lot to get the same vibe as I have. But by bringing the room into vibration and resonance, it kind of invites the audience to become a composer as well, to go and explore, like, how does this pipe sound? How does it sound if you go underwater? How does it sound if you touch it? How the sound if you move, you're not fixed to any chair. You can say that this format is somewhere in between being a sound installation and just a regular improvised concert. And by doing that, I hope that the listener is also getting like emotionally moved by the music, just as I am. So there's a resonating part, which is like on a physical level, I would like to create resonance. But there's also resonance as an emotional level that I would like to create a room where the listener feel that they can resonate with me and the room and the world, basically.